Sandhan. All Gujarat Integrated Classroom.
Satellite na madhyam thi jodti kadi, etle Sandhan.
Good afternoon, friends and my dear student. Today we are continuing with the tissue culture. As you know that the tissue cultures are of two type. One is the plant tissue culture and second one is the animal tissue culture. So we are today talking about the plant tissue culture, tools of the plant tissue culture and the techniques, basic or the general techniques which we are using under the plant tissue culture. So here, what is, first of all, we are introduce about what is the plant tissue culture. Plant tissue culture. Plant tissue culture is a collection of experimental methods of growing large number of isolated cells or tissues under and controlled conditions. The cells and the tissues are obtained from any part of the plant like stem, root, leaf, etc. That means we know that the plant having the different part, and basically if we want to develop the new plant under the septic condition, and that are the basic three parts: stem, root and the leaf. So the basic technique what we are using under the control condition on the base of experimental, we are calling it is the plant tissue culture, which are encouraged to produce more cells in culture and to express their totipotency. Now, what is totipotency? Totipotency, that is the genetic ability to produce the more plants. Cells or tissues are grown in different types of vial, contains a medium with mineral nutrients, vitamins and phytohormones. To carry out the experiment, we should use the particular tissue culture that we are using. One of the technique is known as the tissue culture technique. A well-equipped laboratory is also the first required. So now we are talking about the tissue culture laboratory. An ideal tissue culture laboratory should have at least two big rooms and a small room. One big room is for general laboratory work such as preparation of media, autoclaving, distillation of water, etc. The other room is for keeping cultures under controlled light, temperature and humidity. The small room is for aseptic work and for keeping autoclaved articles. Now we are talking about that general laboratory for the tissue culture techniques. Provided following articles and the arrangements. Very first is a washing area. It should be provided with a large sink, running hot and cold water, brushes of various sizes, detergent, and a bucket of single distilled water for a final rinse of the washing or the washed glass goods. Plastic buckets are required for soaking the glass goods to be washed. Another separate bucket with lid is also required for disposing of the used or infected media before cleaning. This bucket should be cleaned twice in a week. Now the second one is the hot air oven. We are using the hot air oven for drying the washed glass goods. A number of enamel tray of different sizes are required for keeping wet glass goods inside the oven. Next to that is the refrigerator for storing various thermolabile chemicals like vitamins, hormones, amino acids, casein, hydrolase, yeast extract, coconut milk, etc. So we are freezing that into the refrigerator. Second, that's the stock solution of the salts are also kept to prevent the contamination. Weighing balance. There are three types of the weighing balance are used for weighing, in laboratory for weighing chemicals, sugars, agar-agar and others. Like very first, that's the pan balance, second chemical balance, and third electric balance. Now the distillation plant. A single distillation and a double distillation water plants are indispensable. Two big plastic containers are required for storing the distilled water. So our laboratory also having one of the distillation plant and with a two big plastic container. Why we are using that, or why the laboratory require that two container as a plastic, that for storing the distilled water. Now we are talking about the pH meter. So before coming on the pH meter, we having the very good figure as a pH meter. Now this is the instrument what we use as a pH meter. Here is the figure. See, this is the figure of the pH meter. Any solution what we are keep inside to this beaker, and then two wires are connected with this machines by which we can identify any pH, whether it is related with the acidic medium or the basic medium, by this instrument. Now here we are. What is the purpose of this is that this is the pH meter used for the measurement and adjustment of the nutrient medium. As I told you about that, whether it is acidic or basic. Basic, that means in the form of alkaline conditions. Now vacuum pump, it is required for filtering liquid media, sugar solution, etc. Through filter apparatus using air suction. Now autoclave. Now here is again one of that figure what we shown here as a autoclave. Autoclave is that type of the instrument. See, here is the very good instrument what we are calling that it is the simple operable or autoclave. We can operate by our own hands. This is the just like a pressure cooker we having in our tissue culture laboratory. So what is the aim of that particular, that we are talking right now about the autoclave. The important for the sterilization of nutrient media, glass goods and the instrument. Now we are going about, this is the particular microscope we are supposed to use to observe the different organism or the colonies what we are grown onto the slide. So here the special type of the microscope what we have to use. So that is also required in our general plant tissue culture laboratory. We are talking about now the heater. Heater we need for to heating or warming the medium to dissolve agar, to melt the agarified medium. Microscope, as I shown you before, that we having the three type of the microscope basically requiring the tissue culture laboratory. One is the simple, second one is the compound, third one is the inverted, and binocular dissection microscopes are essential for various purposes. Some of the microscopes should be fitted with a camera for taking photo micrographs. So those micrographs what we are using that as it is called the photo micrographs. Now one of the instrument which is also there we require in our laboratory, and that is the microtome and the wooden racks. That is microtome is needed for the sectioning. And now here is one of that microscope what we call the binocular. Here one of that instrument what I shown you, that's the lamellar flow. Okay, so now we are talking about the microtome and the wooden racks. Microtome is needed for sectioning the culture tissues. Wooden racks are required for keeping the various chemicals in the racks. Now, this is the laboratory for the aseptic inoculation. Room should be without any window or ventilator in order to make it dust-free. The room should be provided with double doors. The door should have two automatic door closer. For entering into the room, shoes should be left outside. For simple routine works such as aseptic seed germination, harvesting of culture tissue from the aseptic stock for cytological work or for microtome preparation, a small inoculating hood may be used and can be placed on a small table. Now the lamellar flow. Now this is the very good, very first requirement what we need during the plant tissue culture. So if we culture any, either the cell, either the tissue, either the embryo culture, we having in our laboratory, we should work with the number of culture. For example, anther culture, protoplast culture, cell culture, then we having embryo culture. So the different cultures we are methodologies of that we are doing under the laboratory, and all commonly we are calling it is the bioculture. So for that, one instrument what we have to use in our laboratory is the lamellar L flow. Now this is the figure what I want to show, that this is the figure of the lamellar flow. Now the simple, before that we are using this type of the structure. This is the instrument, this is the glass based structure. Here is the back neat like condition, and upper side this is the roof. So here the instrument, it is known as a lamellar air flow. Air are coming out from here and the net like conditions. Okay, so now what is the aim of that lamellar air flow? Lamellar air flow cabinet is the most suitable, convenient and reliable instrument for aseptic work. It is allows one to work for a longer period, which is not possible inside the inoculation chamber. One can work openly and easily for a longer period on the table of the lamellar air flow. Lamellar air flow has a number of small blower motors to blow airs, which passes through a number of HEPA. Now what is the meaning of HEPA? That is high efficiency particulate air. Once again repeating, that what is HEPA? That is high efficiency particulate air that is filtered. Before starting work, lamellar air flow is put on for 10 to 15 minutes. The flow of air does not put out the flame of a spirit lamp. Therefore, a spirit lamp can be used conveniently during the work. Now we are talking about the main part or the important part of the media preparation room. An area is required for preparation of the media is known as the media preparation room. So for media preparation room, the area should be required. Second, the space should be provisioned for chemicals, labware, culture vessels, closures and miscellaneous equipment required for media preparation and dispersing. In this room, provision is also made for placing hot plates or stirrers, pH meter, balance, water bath, brush nurse, oven, autoclave, culture, vessel, refrigerator, etc. So we have in our laboratory one of the room in which we are keeping this all the type of the instrument regarding as once again what we are preparing the plates as we are calling the petri dish for the culturing of the different microorganism, for the culturing of the different tissues, for the culturing of the embryo. Then nowadays we are using the haploid plant. So for that also we are culturing different types of the haploid plants. Then we having the embryo. Embryo also we are supposed to be grown up, which are immature. We can definitely culture that particular immature embryo and then when culture into the new plant. So before coming on that plant, these are the requirement which will be there, that should be there in our laboratory. So we have one of the room of the provision that for placing hot plates or strays, pH meters, balance, water brush, water bath, burner, oven, autoclave, culture, vessels and the refrigerator. Now vitamins and the growth hormones are carefully weighed because it is the most important to grow any type of the cell or the tissue starting from that. So it is required to maintain that condition, that proper weight of the vitamins and growth hormones should be there. Stock solution of the chemicals are kept in refrigerator to avoid contamination. So to avoid the contamination, definitely whatever the stock solutions are there of the different chemicals, we should kept under the refrigerator, which are kept under the inside to the laboratory. Now here is what is tissue culture. Now up to this we have take reference regarding to the tools which are the instrument which we are used under the tissue culture laboratory. Now we are talking about the tissue culture technique. Refer to the techniques of the growing plant cells, tissues, organs, seeds or other plant parts in a sterile environment on a nutrient medium, that is called tissue culture. So once again repeating what